Hey, Frontline fans, welcome back to Comic Frontline and fans. You're back with me, Mike Spider Slayer, getting ready to do Spider Slayer's Hall number 3. That's right, guys. This is the weekly video series where me, Mike Spider Slayer, goes to the comic store and brings home all his comics and goodies and stuff like that and shares it with all of you. So this week, guys, I don't think there was maybe a ton of, like, big comics, but there was a decent amount of comics. I got some of them, and I got something probably that's really anticipated that was for free. So I'll show that to you now. So here we go. Here is this week's bag, and the comics are inside. Which ones did I get is a big mystery. So here we go, guys. Hope everyone's having a good week and is excited for the new comic week. So, all right, bag is on the floor, and let's get started. So first things off is I got a whole bunch of bookmarkers. I always grab them when I'm here for my graphic trip, for my trades. And my son reads like 50 books a year, so he always needs those. So definitely got that. Next thing I wound up getting is a DC Universe Rebirth checklist. That's right, guys. Save the date, May 25th. 2016 is that it's here, and everyone's excited for it, and it gives you the little checklist on the back on everything that's coming out. So in May, DC Universe Rebirth Special number 1 is out, so wound up getting that. And the next thing I wound up getting is another one of those. This was also in my book. And then I think I got this previews book last week, but they shoved it in there again this week because they probably had too many of those. So I wound up getting that. And the coolest thing that's probably in here, I think, is maybe besides better than all the comics this week, is the DC Comics free previews for DC Universe Rebirth. That's right, guys. Now, if you go to your local comic book shop, you can probably pick this up. My comic store only had so many, and obviously they put them in all the subscribers' pull boxes. And then when they had the leftovers on the shelf, there was probably only about 20 left over. So I'm assuming that this is going to be a limited supply. This is giving you everything about Rebirth, everything in here, anything that you want to read about. So what I'm going to do after this video, after the haul series, I'm going to read up on some of this, and I'm going to do a video on the DC Comics previews on kind of what to expect in some of these stories. So go a little bit more into depth with this. So we, you know, we all learn what's happening in DC Rebirth because we can't wait. So yes, very excited about that. All right. So now let's get into this week's comics. Which comics did I actually pick up? Well, the first one that I wound up grabbing is A-Force issue number 4. I'm not sure. I think this is the last issue of this creative team, maybe this one or the next one, with Kelly Thompson and Willow Wilson and George Molina, who are the artists on this book. The book is absolutely gorgeous, guys. I love this book, and I will be really disappointed when this creative team goes. Just everything is really well drawn, and the story is fun, and Singularity is fun, and just awesome looking stuff here. So I can't wait to read A-Force issue number 4. All right, next we have All New X-Men issue number 8. Here we have Doctor Strange working with Beast in this issue, and it's funny how this drops because the Doctor Strange trailer just came out last night, so this is perfect for them to drop this. Mark Bagley does the artwork in this book, and it looks absolutely outstanding. Definitely looking forward to this book and seeing really the direction that it's going in, as it's focused on a couple different characters. This one obviously looks like this time around it's going to focus around Beast, as we've already gotten to see a little bit of Angel, X-23, Scott Summers, and yeah, again, like I said, they're going to talk about Beast here. So this is All New X-Men issue number 8. It's kind of hard to believe we're on issue 8 already. All right, next goes to the only standoff book I think I'm going to get going forward. I'm done reading those tie-in books. They just don't seem like they deal with the story very much. And so this time it's All New Avengers, All New All Different Avengers, issue number 8. it just felt like this book came out like last week. I guess it was 2 weeks ago when this came out, where it had to do with a different Maria Hill or whatnot. And we got to see that Kubrick winds up putting the heroes in a globe, and Miles Morales doesn't know where he's at with Tony Stark. So really interesting to see where the direction is going to go with this whole standoff situation. If it ties into Civil War or whatnot, I'm not sure yet, but we'll see where it goes. So it's all new, all different Avengers standoff. Case file number 8. Don't forget that. Next is the all exciting, all amazing Spider-Man issue number 10. Still dealing with the Scorpio gang, and it doesn't look like it's going to end anytime soon until this Dead No More story arc comes out. And I feel like Dan Slott's putting all his eggs on his basket when it comes to this new Amazing Spider-Man volume with that story arc, because so far these stories in the Amazing Spider-Man volume have just been lackluster. And last issue, you got to see Spidey go into space and fall from the moon in a spacesuit, and he didn't get burned up. And then at the end, you're left with Scorpio waiting for Spider-Man to do battle. So I don't know what's going to happen in this issue. So we'll see where it goes. The Amazing Spider-Man issue number 10. All right. Next goes to Darth Vader issue number 19, as it continues this story with this whole queen and these resources. And I don't know. I've been kind of falling off of Darth Vader a little bit in this story arc ever since Vader Down. I've been a little bit disappointed with it. It hasn't impressed me as much as it used to. I wanted to get through this particular story arc and see this a new arc and a new direction, and seeing what's going to happen with Darth Vader next. So I don't know. His little Aphra, I think that was her name, is in jail, and the rebels have recently rescued her from the Star Wars series. So how that ties together, I'm sure we'll find out in the future. But until then, we're going to read Darth Vader issue number 19. All right. Next, we have the continuation of the Green Lantern Corps, Edge of Oblivion, issue number 4. Looks like this book is going to lead into DC Rebirth as well, and the reuniting of the Green Lantern Corps. We got to see the main villain in this book in the last issue become a Green Lantern, and she kind of corrupted the ring to make her into a Green Lantern. So where does that go? Where does it take the series from here? I don't know. But when you open up the book, you have Kilowog, who's like in jail. So we'll see where it goes. I like Tom Taylor's writing. He gives the characters a lot of emotion, and he makes you care for the characters, and that's what makes this series so interesting. So this is Green Lantern Corps issue number 4. That rhymes. All right. Next, we go on to issue number 7 of Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, the last issue was a very emotional issue, especially for Kitty Pryde, as we got to see that these alien races were being held captive. It reminded her of a concentration camp. And it was a very emotional issue, like I said, and I really enjoyed it. The only thing that was missing from a Guardians of the Galaxy, from that Guardians of the Galaxy book, was the Guardians of the Galaxy. It was a perfect Kitty Pryde and Peter Quill book. But this time around, hopefully we see more of the Guardians. It progresses this story, so this is Guardians of the Galaxy issue number 7. All right, next is a long-awaited book, and that is Spidey issue number 4. It didn't come out last month, so I think we're getting 2 this month. But I've been waiting for this one a long time, as he gets to do battle against a classic version of Doctor Doom. And my son's been waiting for this because he loves reading this with me. And it's a good introduction for a lot of younger people out there that don't know too much about Spider-Man and kind of want to get that classic history. And this is a modern day feel book. So I really enjoy it. I can't wait to see his fight against flipping Dr. Doom in this book. I'm so excited for it. So really good book, and check it out if you haven't yet. This is my Spidey book so far. All right, next goes to X-Men 92 issue 2. This came out 2 weeks ago, as we get to see our X-Men doing battle against Alpha Red, who is the Russian, or is it the Canadians? I forgot. It's the Russians' version of Captain America. It's like some monstrosity, and it's the X-Men that are going to have to go and stop him and save the day. I'm waiting to see how this book turns out in the long haul and the true direction does it go. Is it more like an episodic type of tale where it takes place one or two issues and then it's like a cartoon and then it goes to the next, you know, episode? Or is it more just like story arcs, or is it a combination of both? I don't know. We'll see. But I think the tales are endless here. And this can be a really strong comic book. So this is X-Men 92, issue 2. Very iconic feel here. Really like that. All right, and next goes to Mockingbird, issue number 2. Here we get to see her in the, it's got this kind of dominatrix outfit that she's wearing here. Now, this looks like it ties into that first issue, because if you remember in the first issue of Mockingbird, she was in the doctor's office or in the Shield's doctor office with this actual outfit on. So we'll probably see what happens before she went to that doctor's office that day on what mission she was on. And I can tell you what, when I was searching through this book in the racks of the comic store, I'm like, yeah, there's some crazy stuff going on with Bobby here. A lot of people in leather and on tables with candles, whips and chains, and I don't know. So Mockingbird issue number 2. All right, last but not least, guys, we got a book that's been in the works, and I think it was delayed, and now it's finally come out after The Force Awakens, and this is Star Wars C-3PO, issue number 1. This is a long-awaited issue to find out how he gets that flipping red arm. Like, who really gives a flying fuck how he gets this red arm? But for some reason, it's drawing attention. So I'm like, all right, I'm going to get it. I'm going to find out why he gets the red arm. And not only am I going to find out how he gets the red arm, I'm going to review this comic book to tell you guys how he got that red arm. So if you haven't read it yet, read it. And I'm going to do a review on it. We're going to talk about it, because I want to see what makes this book worth $5. So there you have it, guys. There is Spider Slayer's Haul for the Week, Episode 3. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Now it's your turn in the comments below to tell us what comics you got for the week, which ones you're most excited for, maybe some you're not so excited for. And fans, as always, thank you for watching Comic Frontline. And until the next comic book review, this is Mike Spider Slayer saying thank you and have a great week, everyone. Take care. Bye.